Welcome back to the Turnabout to Eldorado. And this looks different, you might be thinking. You would be thinking correctly. Sure enough, because after my attempt to change from one screen to two screens in the last video, it did not work as intended. It did not work as intended whatsoever. So hopefully that didn't come out too horribly last video, but we're going to try a different setup. Because Pyrite has... a lot of new display settings. Unfortunately, they have horizontal screens, which is an odd offset thing. And they have the small bottom screen, which unfortunately is a just probably too small, but it's an improvement over just the two screens, top and bottom, in my personal opinion. Hopefully you agree. If this doesn't go well, then we can always try the, whatchamacallit. Try the horizontal screen just to see how it looks. But yeah, very interesting new display settings. So, when we last left off, Mr. Lex here was about to become a Bond villain. I was 1 second away from him admitting that. Oh my. That's some kinky foreplay. Victoria seems like a really cool girl. Cool gal. Right up ahead. Ugh. My legs. Is this the old man in the cabin? Oh shit, it is. What kind of meeting is... Ta-da! Tiny, delicate flower! Flower needs help. Okay, fair enough. The Army General. Yeah, really ironic. Unknowingly. Knife? No, or maybe not. Okay. So I gotta admit, this is really charming. Absolutely charming case. Little odd how the setup has been going so far, with everything stacking against him and random Adam and Eve out of nowhere, but other than that, the writing is really charming so far, I gotta admit. Victoria is my favorite character, and I'm sad that she sees the victim here. I am sad. Yeah, I'm not too fond of a plan. Papers. How do we perfect enough? Bigfoot, myth, or cash grab? Rogue FBI agent carrying dangerous weapons. I can't read that bottom one, but. Identity of body in land meat mountains revealed years after discovery. Rogue FBI agent. Very interesting paper. What animal will he examine this time? Oh boy. Let's just try not to die. We don't even know what we're up against, do we? Ah, Victoria and her case. Of sorts. Seems like a rather ridiculous amount of time. Hmm. really probably just didn't think of it as absolutely critical. Not even check my. Okay, I guess it's outside of our court record this time. A recess for Emma can tell, so Emma can tell us what actually has been going on with Victoria. Maybe a whole bunch of some things. Good plan. I like that plan. Oh. Looks very nice this big. Is he going to be prosecuting his own case? That just really popped into my head, but... Did I really call it? Understanding. Yeah, Winston, old chap. Oh boy. Single-handedly led the charge. I highly doubt that, but... Is this your last case, Payne? Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh, Payne's been buffed. Years ago. Clearly, something had happened between them. Always the poet, Your Honor. Fully with decisive evidence. Okay. We'll certainly do our best. How, we don't know, but that is our intent. Yeah, he's doing quite well. Alright, victim, Victoria Nova, was killed in an abandoned hut in Ravenview Forest. Her body, on the other hand, was found in the defendant's car. On the scene, we found evidence that the car was there. The murder weapon, an old knife, was confirmed to belong to Mr. Greenwell as well. All this suggests the defendant killed Miss Nova, and then put her body in the car. Fair enough. I very much doubt that. And you're very right, yes. Okay. Okay. Living off the wild. Sure. This is interesting. I was not expecting that to take the place of the main screen there. Well, it's gotta be worth something. Let's press it. Oh, pizza coupons. Pretty much. Nah. not a thing. Before things get worse, yeah. So I guess the hut is... Yeah, I think... Ah, okay. I like this kind of... I like this setup kind of, sort of. Oops. Which, this left path doesn't really seem to go to the hut. Although, I guess you could get there if you take the left path. Although, maybe we're just about to comment on that. Oh, yep. And if you didn't want to leave an obvious trail that you were going to the hut, it would kind of make sense to disguise the way you approach. We're more concerned with the person that we can prove. Of King Ramses. Thanks, Ramses. Preserved. Elsewhere, we may very well have. Well, I guess we'll press this again. Yeah, funny how things work out. A nice variation, I suppose. We need to find a hole. Well... Is it really the Army of Stars? I need to read this paper, though, before we do anything important. Bigfoot, myth, or cash grab? Identity of body in Land Meat Mountains has revealed Is mountains revealed 8 years after discovery. Rogue FBI agent carrying dangerous bioweapon? Oh no. So I think the proof against that is this. Army of Stars. That she came to that exact place for some reason. That is entirely possible. From a friggin' mental institution, I don't think she would have been the one getting suspicious. I'd say Luke would have been the one getting suspicious. Maybe Luke was just eager to meet her again, and they both agreed on a location they both remember. Then where'd her cut go? Okay, where'd her car go? I guess the tire tracks? The only one car drove? One, it would probably still be there. And her car would still be there? I feel like that would be more important than there only being one set of tracks. Because, I mean, who would have driven her car away from the crime scene? Obvious. But, no, I mean, I literally couldn't have done better myself, Gumshoe. Oh, okay. So that statement's updated. Oh, I'd imagine the fact that he drove her there creates the problem of why would he put her body in the trunk and drive her away? I think we need to press the statement about the body in the trunk. Let's press this, see if anything changes. Greenwell's car, and we have the body photograph. So, I say we start with the body photograph. Okay, good. We should end up raising the question that I brought up already. Why would he not leave her body at the scene? Moving on. Away from the scene. The knife, right? We're certainly driving this point home. We have no proof to support our theory, but we have the momentum. Prepared. Very interesting. Who knows? Who cares? Yeah. As quick as he flip-flopped, he has a point. The best is yet to come. Oh no. One testimony coming right up. How I caught him. On the night of the crime, I was driving down the road in the city outskirts, pal. Suddenly, I was overtaken by a car matching the defendant's description. I was already going fast myself, so he was obviously speeding. I signaled to him to pull over, which he did. I approached the car. I noticed the trunk wasn't fully closed. I then went to the driver. It was the defendant wearing a surgical mask. Oh. Suspicious enough, I went and opened the trunk. And that's how I found her, pal. Whew. Yeah, that's a new one. Which means it's obviously not a prank, it's an intentional attempt to get Lucas caught. Well, let's see where this goes. Ooh. It's green. What can he say? It's green. It's not easy being green. Adored. A sturdle wagon? Gumshoe's a car guy? Gumshoe's a car guy. Bad eyesight saved the day. Yeah. trunk had to have been partially closed. I'd say something's amiss. I'd argue with you calling it worthless, but... He got kazooed. Good shot, Emma. Good shot. This part intrigues me. Out of it. It's entirely possible he did have feelings for her, and probably still did, even after all this mess. God, that was a long monologue. And there's still two statements to go. Okay. Here comes the moment of truth. So what the hell do we need to do here? Hmm. here. Another reason he would have been out of it. More hands-on approach. Got that wrong. For shame. Okay, I don't know, and this video is running along a bit too much, so we'll figure this out in time.